You were great at Washington State there with Coach Leach that we'll get to, but, you know, you were putting the mustache on him. There was all of that that went on in it, and you live loudly. You live yourself. The jorts are out there. People were handing out mustaches at the game. I'm curious, was there ever any pushback to that? Because quarterback is a position where we don't often let people be themselves the way you were.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think there's been a ton of pushback. You know, I think if you start sucking, obviously there's going to be pushback.
That's usually how it goes.
Yeah, mustache looks pretty stupid at that point. But no, it's been great. You know, I think I've kind of found my people in Jacksonville. You know, just the right amount of white trashiness for me. So we're having a great time down there and loving it.
Listen, Minshew Mania is with us. And I guess it makes all the sense in the world how your NFL career started, because it sort of encapsulates how you got to Washington State and Mike Leach anyway. For those that don't know, you were set to go to Alabama and be a backup quarterback and sort of train for what was going to be a coaching job, right? And then Mike Leach said to you, why would you want to do that when you can come lead the country in passing yards at Washington State? And lo and behold, you did. Tell me about his recruiting pitch and what it was like to being there with that crazy Leach, who's now, of course, in Mississippi competing for the hearts and minds with Lane Kiffin, which is the most insane thing of all time.
Yeah, so, like, I started watching, like, Texas Tech cutups when I was in eighth grade. That's what we were running out in high school. So I've always loved Leach. You know, all his interviews and stuff, that's fun. But, like, his football, like, he was always a guy, like, I would dream to play for. So whenever he called, he didn't have to say anything. I was sold. I was ready to go.
Yeah, it's so fascinating, and he's such a different guy. We all obviously know that playing for him behind closed doors. Who was Mike Leach, the coach, for you guys day-to-day like?
No, he's the exact same. You know, how you see him in interviews, he gets off on those same tangents in meetings. But, you know, biggest thing I learned from Coach Leach is how he treats everybody the same. You know, whether you're the lowest guy, top guy, he treats everybody the same with respect. And, you know, I love playing for him.
You said you guys had a specific job in those meetings when he started going off on tangents, though,
yeah,
right?
So if you're in a QB meeting, the strategy is, like, say Leach is right there. If he starts telling a story, you just got to turn and look at the screen, and then he'll realize, oh, wait, I'm not talking to anybody. Let's keep this meeting going.
So if he locked eyes, it was over.
If he has a captive audience, like, you're done.
That is awesome.
We'll be 30 minutes late to practice.
Awesome. Gardner Minshew joining us again, sixth-round pick into Jacksonville this year. So what was told to you going into this offseason about the quarterback position next year and where it's all going to be going?
Yeah, you know, as of right now, we're both in the – in the same QB room,
right,
getting ready for next year. I think, you know, whoever it is, we're going to give our team a good chance to win. And, you know, I just had, you know, lunch with Nick a few days ago, and, you know, we're both on the same mission. We both want to see each other do well, and, you know, we're excited to see what the
certainly
what the
you both want to start. I get that.
Yeah,
we all
absolutely
understand that. But from the coaching standpoint, were you told it's an open competition or how it was going to work going into the end
of
the year?
Yeah, no, it's going to be open. We're going to battle it out. But more than anything, we're trying to make each other better to get our team better.
So so as you get set – sorry to interrupt there.
No, you're good.
As you get set for year two, what thing would you tell year two Gardner Minshew that year one Gardner Minshew wasn't aware of? Like, what was the hardest thing? Oh, I know how to do this. Wait, whoa, I was not expecting this.
Yeah, I'd say the biggest thing is, like, I've never had a problem with fumbles until this year, but, like, everybody's just faster. Like, they get their, you know, they can reach you from here. Like, we got guys, you know, with long, long arms. So just understanding, you know, and I think by the end of the year I kind of got that a little better, but, you know, just the speed is, you know, different.
Gardner Minshew with us here on Golic and Wingo. All right, we mentioned it in the open here. It took everyone by storm going into this offseason. You talked about the RV trip that you just went on, touring this great nation as only, I think, the greats can, in an RV with a bunch of your buddies. So you just dropped off the RV. Give us the highlights. How was the trip? Where did you end up going?
Yeah, it was incredible. So started in Mississippi, went through Texas, up to Telluride, Colorado for a couple days, which was one of the coolest places I've ever been to. Absolutely beautiful. To Vegas, where I got to fly with the Air Force Thunderbirds, which was like like lifetime experience. That was incredible.
I did that once. Wow. Super 50. It was insane.
Oh, I passed out. Yeah. They messed me up pretty good, but it was so much fun. Like, I don't think I'd do it again, but doing it one time was absolutely perfect. Awesome, get to see what they do, and then eventually made it out to the Pacific and worked my way back.
And really incredible. And it's kind of been a family affair. Your father, Flint, was nice enough to come on our Golic family podcast with me and Mike and his brother and sister and sister-in-law and my wife. And he's a great guy, Flint. Great. And he's kind of riding this wave as well. How is what does he say through all this? And how has he been enjoying the limelight?
Yeah, no, he's loving it, man, because he saw, like, you know, when I didn't have any offers out of high school, when I walked on, when I went to junior college, he always talks about how he's getting splinters in his butt and the bleachers in freaking Mississippi Delta Community College. You know, so he's loving life right now, man, and that's kind of the fun thing about this all is, you know, all the people that, you know, saw every step of the way and were with me through it all. So that's what makes all of it.
Listen, the whole thing has been fun.
It really has.
And you
been.
Embracing the Uncle Rico thing for a shoot for all of it has been phenomenal.
Hey everyone, thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports, more analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus. We'll see you there.